Hey guys, Stay Patient here, and we're back to carry on with our Ratchet and Clank playthrough. Of course, we are on challenge mode now. We're going for all the trophies, and we don't have a huge amount left to do, so we're just going to work on finishing up our weapons, leveling them up, and finishing challenge mode, of course. Finishing off our health upgrades, all those little last few trophies that most people have left when they're playing this game. I have about an hour, for now at least. I have some medication that I take first thing in the morning, and I'm not allowed to eat for an hour after it, so we are going to do a quick hour on this, then I'm going to get some breakfast and then carry on straight away after and get this game finished today, I would think. So hopefully the whole playthrough will be up by sometime tomorrow probably, because it takes some time to upload the videos to YouTube. I think we're done on this planet. Let's have a look. We've still got some weapons to buy once we've got the bolts, so we want to try and get our multiplier up and get those bolts nice and quickly. And let's just remind ourselves of which weapons we're using here. We have got the Plasma Slayer on the second weapon wheel, which we have to remember to try and use. But all of these weapons, I believe... Oh no, the Doom Blades, okay. Right, we can actually swap the Plasma Striker, or Plasma Stalker, whatever it's called, for, let's see, Plasma Slayer it's called now, because we've upgraded it to the Omega version. Swap that out for the Doom Blades, just to make sure all the weapons we're using are ones that require XP. So, let's do it. I do need to do something I have forgotten to do. While we're loading up the next banner here, yeah, let's head over to the next planet here. I'm just going to open up my stream so I can see anybody's chat. Let's have a looky look. Twitch. There we go. Just to make sure if anyone does join us. I don't think anyone will, because a lot of our regulars from America, and it's very, very early for them. Although we do have some that tend to stay up until about this time in the morning sometimes. Crazy people. I couldn't do
Captain,
that.
Come in. Clank and I are in position and ready to commence Operation Falling Star.
Okay.
Copy that. You're clear to move in.
We're good.
Monitor your position from here.
Right, so we're going to do all the side objectives as well, because to be honest, it takes longer to level up the... it takes longer to level up the weapons than it does to finish challenge mode. So if you just blitz through challenge mode, you need to start a new playthrough anyway, so I might as well do all these side objectives just to help us get a bit extra XP, and also we might need some of these gadgets as well, because the gadgets you've collected from the first playthrough don't carry across to challenge mode. Of course, we have to do all these little side sections again to pick them up. Some of them are necessary, some of them are just optional. This one I believe is necessary. Oh. I always check to see if little scenes like that are cutscenes. Make sure we skip them just in case there's some copyright on the footage. So now we can swap what these, let's have a look, swap what these little gadget bots function is.
Thank you, but there is still a prototype device nearby. I will collect it for you.
And we're going to try and fly through as much of this as we can in the next hour. What time is it? It's just gone 8. yeah, so I'm definitely hoping to get this game finished off today, and then I can get back to doing the Overwatch trophy guides that so many of you have been enjoying and finding helpful. Yeah, Overwatch, very, very good game, a lot of fun. Looking forward to playing some more of that, trying to get some of those crazy difficult trophies done and get some guides up. It's quite a fun game to try and get the trophies on, to be honest, although they are difficult. Difficult games are always rewarding. You know, you feel good for having earned them. Oh, we need to grab this bridge bot. Use him again. One good thing about this playthrough is that because we've already got the trophy for unlocking all the trespasser puzzles manually in one playthrough, we can just skip those now. We can just press the button that sort of auto-hacks them. That'll speed things up a bit, not having to do those little hacking puzzles again. Right, so pop that one on there to keep the door open. And through we go. Oh, it's already a power bot, isn't it? So anyone looking for a sort of guideline as to how long this game usually takes, it's going to probably take me about 12 hours this time.
There they are.
I would say on your first playthrough, it's likely to be 15 if you don't know the game. But it's certainly not a long game, they're very enjoyable. It's just the right length, Ratchet. I think. The pacing is really good. Oh, my tummy's rumbling.
To your position now.
You might be able to hear it through the microphone, actually. Oh, I must be hungry. Right, yeah, that was necessary, that section we just did. Picking up the Magna Boots.
Too puny to wear the Magna Boots himself. Clank, return them to Ratchet.
Alrighty,
Ratchet, what's your status on Operation Falling Star?
We got a little distracted. We're on it.
Right, so have we got the trespasser yet? Yes. Yeah, here we go. Oh yeah, we can auto hack, can't we? Why not? Probably would have been quicker just to finish it off ourselves, but I'm going to try and get into the habit of auto hacking just to speed things up.
According to my database, we are headed to a shuttle designed for transporting Drek's high-value experiments. Well, I'll give him this. He stays busy. Let's go see what he's been making.
Oh. Yeah, it's very early here. This is probably the earliest I've ever streamed, to be honest. Hopefully I'm not waking anybody... Sorry, hopefully I'm not waking anybody up. Get my words out. You can tell I'm still half asleep. Right, what weapons are we using? Oh, let's get this to level 9, shall we? Oh, this is level 5 already as well. We need to get them leveled up to the Amiga version. Let's get Zircon out, start working on him. Let's get this Lavacito, I think it's called now. Was the Pyrositor? Oh, Lavacite. I think it was Lavacite. I was like, what's that all about? What does that name mean? But I guess it's lava, isn't it? Lavacite, or Lavacitor, as they probably pronounce it. Where's Zircon? Is he disappeared already? Oh. Hello, stinky aliens. Come on. Right, some Raritanium here, which we need a nice lot of. Let's just check our cards, because the more card packs we unlock, then the more, you know, when we get duplicates, if we trade them in for some of these missing ones, and we fill in some of these packs of three, then it will increase our drop rates of some of the items that we need a lot of. Oh, okay, so we've already actually got the... Yeah, we've already got the gadget. That did carry over from one playthrough to the next. What was that then? I can't remember now. Let's just pop one of these here just to get a bit of XP for it, and then we'll just run past. It's not going to necessarily kill them, but it will get some XP in the process. Oh, that's quite cool. I've just noticed that obviously this was the this being the second playthrough, for some reason that particular gadget carries over. So when we picked it up, when we picked up the gadget, when we went to where the gadget usually is, it was actually Raritanium instead of the gadget itself. So whenever you've already picked up a gadget and you've already got it, it gives you Raritanium in its place. And on the way back, I noticed that the enemies sort of called out that I'd stolen the Raritanium rather than... I really can't remember what gadget it was that you pick up from that area. But that was quite cool that the enemies were kind of adjusted to recognize that you'd already got it and that it wasn't the gadget you'd stolen that time, it was actually some Raritanium. I don't know, I just find little things like that, little touches, quite thoughtful. Because a lot of games would just copy and paste the dialogue, and you'd be like, hang on, I didn't even steal, you know, the box breaker or whatever it was. auto hack.
You're doing great, Ratchet. Keep going. I'll be with you every step.
What's our multiplier at the moment? I think we lost it recently, didn't we? Okay. Yeah, we do need to keep our multiplier built up if we can. Because we need probably a couple million more bolts for the rest of the weapons. The Rhino itself, the upgrade to the Rhino costs a million just on its own, and the rest are sort of several hundred thousand. Probably more like 3 million actually in total. let's use our sniper from here, shall we? Okay, oh, now we've got, or in a minute, we've got the big boss guy, haven't we? We can use him to level up quite a few of our weapons, I should think. Damn it, come on. Is he level 5? Yeah, he's level 5 as well. We want to try and buy the upgrade for the Doom gloves fairly soon, so that we can get that one leveled up and out of the way, because it's the kind of weapon that you can only use in certain situations when the enemy's on the floor. So a lot of the bosses you can't really use it against, because... unless there's an upgrade for it where they jump up into the air, that might be helpful. Hey, getting our multiplier up a bit. Times 5. Come on, times 6. You hear a little noise every time the multiplier goes up, like a ding, or whatever you want to call it. Oh. Haha. This sniper's getting nice and powerful now. It can one-hit a lot of the enemies if you get them in the critical spot, the weak spot. Let's use it to take these guys out. Because it's nice it slows down time now, is what that upgrade for. For the slowdown, which makes it easier to aim at their weak spots or their critical points. boom. Right, level 7 on this one. There is a little hidden area that did have a gold bolt, so I wonder what it's got this time. Probably just a ton of bolts. Oh, and some Raritanium, by the looks of it. Cool. 12,000 bolts from that little area. We've got the times 10 at the moment. Right, let's get some Zerkons on the go. Got a nice range on them now. Look, shooting them from all the way back here. Oh, they shot the button for the next Terrier as well. Don't really want to get hit at this point. Not with a fairly decent multiplier on the go, so let's try and hang back a bit.
This is a friendly reminder that 857P Echo is not a pet. And you should be copying it instead of
875B Echo. 87, does that 8? I wonder if that's designed to spell something out. I can't really picture it in my head at the moment. 8 would be B, 7 could be... hang on, let's just sort these guys out. Five would be S. B and E. Yeah, B and E at the end. So, B something, S B E. No, it's not, I don't think it's designed to sort of spell anything out. We've not quite got enough for another weapon yet. We've got loads of raritanium though, so that's cool. Let's use some of that. I'm just going to work through the weapons one by one. Let's get them finished off here. Now that we're earning the raritanium nice and quickly, we can just put them into any weapon really. It doesn't matter too much. Oh, the rhino's got a lot to go. Let's leave that just for now. Tidy up some of these other ones. Maybe we can get some of these mystery upgrades on the Raptor launcher.
That's how it's done.
we get all the way around here. Oh, nice. Ah, awesome. There we go. Build up our ammo. Yeah. Okay, let's unlock this. We've got to fight the Snaggle Beast now. Oh, pardon me. Sorry. As I mentioned, it's early in the morning. You can probably tell from my croaky voice. Right. Okay, so we are going to get him dancing. Where's our rhino? Yeah, that's level 5. We don't want to use that until we've got it to level 6. So, let's get Zircon out. Let's get a Protopast out. And then let's try and get some white speed for this Magma Buster, because this should level up quite nice and quickly, seeing as it's one of the earliest weapons you find. You get a nice lot of damage on the Snaggle Beast here with it. I wonder if we can get him dancing again before he runs off. Oh, that's annoying. I lost my multiplier. That's fine though. To be expected. Oh, he didn't last long, did he? Zircon, we're going to need to level him up a bit, I think. Yeah, our next group of Raritanium is going to go on Zircon because usually they last for a nice long time. But with him now at level 7, obviously we're trying to get him to level 10. To be able to do that, we need to get his duration up a bit. Let's have a look here though. Yeah, you can see the XP going up on the top left for this weapon. And he's off again. Oh, we got up to level 6, times 6 multiplier already. That's pretty cool. Some of these little guys must have a decent amount of impact on the multiplier. Times 7. Oh, we haven't got any Zircons left. Oh dear. Oh, let's use a few of these actually. Yeah, ideal time to use these actually. Oh, he's right on top of me. Oh, how did he not hit us there? Bums. Alrighty. We're gonna just hammer him with a bunch of these Doom box. Ruin bombs not lasting all that long either. Oh, is he down? Awesome. Greetings, Blarg. That was pretty quick. Sorry if I'm quite quiet today as well. Captain, it's Ratchet. I'm speaking just a bit quieter than normal because it's early. Hopefully you can hear me over the game. Impressive. Gotta love Quark. Or Zap Brannigan, as I call him. Alrighty, how's our Magma Buster looking? Yeah, see, we got about 2/3 of the way towards level 10 there from level 9. We'd only just got to level 9. So it's quite good, you know, using some of the weaker weapons on bosses, you level them up quite quickly. Pardon me.
Hey, I bet the Rangers would use jetpacks. Should we head to Gaspar and see if we can get some?
I think we've done every... every route on here now. Yes, we have, because the other one was the timed escape one, wasn't it? Where we got the Raritanium instead of the gadget. Yeah, so we've been... that's the way we came back in. Yeah, we've taken those two routes over there. Alrighty, so... okay, we can afford the upgrades for three of these, so let's choose which one we want. The Doom Blades are pretty good. We can use them late on in the game and get them leveled. I think, oh, I'll tell you what, maybe the Fusion Bomb, actually, because that's one of the weaker guns. Yeah, let's do that. And then we'll do the Peacemaker, because that only carries six bullets, so, or six rounds. Oh, how much money have we got? Crumbs. I thought we only had... so we had like 275,000, we spent 270, but... I would totally buy that if I were you. Huh. Okay, we had more than I thought then. Okay, let's pop some of these into the... Zircon? Yeah, that's why he's not lasting very long. Look, he's hardly upgraded at all. So which one's going to give us... let's go this way and get these duration upgrades. Well, it's not duration actually, it's shot count. So it's not how long he lasts, it's how many shots he's got. So if you call in Zircon and there's no enemies around, he'll last for a nice long time because he won't be shooting. But as soon as he starts shooting, I guess because we were against the boss, he was shooting constantly. He wasn't lasting very long as a result. He was using up his ammo count quite quickly.
Where to next? We must learn what Nefarious is up to on planet Gaspar.
Okay, Gaspar, here we come. Oh, crumbs. Oh, I nearly just... what's wrong with me? I nearly dropped a whole pint of water on the floor. Glass was slippery, I think. Okay, Gaspar, this is where all the brains are. We're not going to collect them all again, because all it gives you is Raritanium, so that's going to cut down time on our second playthrough. Just wipe up all this water here that I spilled. Alright, let's put it. I really am tired and clumsy this morning. Okay.
All right, let's go find you a new jetpack.
Have I got something for you?
Okay, so we haven't got the grind boots yet, right? Which he will do as soon as he finds Nefarious. Oh, I'll tell you what we do need to do. What was the gun we just bought? It was the can't think what it's called now. Fusion. Oh yeah, okay. It's not changed its name, thankfully. Fusion bomb needs to swap in for what was it that's level 5? Oh, it might have been the Doom bots actually. Yeah, let's have a look. Yeah, I was there using the Doombots, the Apocalypse Glove. kind of pointlessly on the Snaggle Beast, that's a bit annoying. We wasted some XP there. Anyway, it's all fine. It's all good. Let's swap in the Fusion Bomb, start using that. I'm going to try and get the Fusion Bomb up to like level 9 or so. Same as with the Magma Buster, which is already at level 9, nearly level 10. In fact, we might try and finish this off. let's get the Groover Bomb out just to stop these guys from shooting us so much. okay.
Ratchet, great. Reinforced door. Why does everything have to be made of dense alloy?
I will try. Hang on, what are we doing here?
Not to be offended by that.
Okay. Come on, level 10. Let's go. Let's do it. Oh, Nefarious is like the best bad guy. Right, are these giving us much XP? Not a huge amount, I don't think, but we'll get there with this weapon. Got anyone? No. Okay, I'm gonna try and snipe these guys from a distance. Oh, Brands, that was terrible. It's become quite obvious during this game how bad at sniping I am. Probably why I never play as a sniper in online shooters. Oh, that's a full of feature. I'm very close. Very close to level 10. It's got to come over the next few minutes, hopefully. We can move on to the Fusion Bomb and get those first two early weapons, those weaker weapons, sorted. Get them out of the way so we can focus on the better ones. Make the game a bit easier and quicker. Ooh, no! Oh, you... oh well. I didn't think we were gonna quite overshoot that as far as we did. Can we shoot both of these from a distance? No, not quite. They're too spread apart. It's not the best weapon to use on enemies like this. It's better against groups because of the way the bullets spread out like that, but when you try and hit these guys with one of the bullets at least, then maybe if they're both together like this, we can... Oh, they're not quite in line. And we're out anyway. okay. Let's go. Let's go do that. Oh, picked up some more ammo already. Now this is perfect for these guys. Lots of little this is perfect for this weapon. Lots of the little guys all next to each other, able to hit everything at once. Thanks to them, we're just probably a couple of kills away from level 10. Let's just grab all the bolts around here. Okay. Got some ammo. Yeah, the bolt grabber doesn't work on the ammo. When you pick up the... It's either called the Box Smash or the Bolt Grabber. but it basically does both those things. It smashes all the boxes and all the breakable items around you when you slam on the ground. And it sort of absorbs all the bolts from your vicinity. You don't have to go around picking them all up. They just get pulled in. But it doesn't work for ammo, so you do need to get up close to ammo to be able to pick it up. B, there we go. First weapon up to max level. So onto the fusion bomb now. Which, wow, look at that. We haven't used it at all yet, and it's given us a huge chunk of XP just from that one hit. Again, because it's one of the... Oh, wow, look at that. Loads of XP. It's because it's the first weapon you have in the game, level 7 already. And so if you use it later on in the game, like we are now, we're about halfway through the playthrough, I think. It gets a nice lot of XP. Ooh. Let's get them dancing, sure. What I'm going to do as well is to save us switching back and forth between the weapon wheels when we want to use the Grubatron. I'm going to swap it out for the Magma Buster, which we're not going to be using again, with it being level 10 already. Right, but we are earning a lot less XP now. All those kills only gave me that tiny slither in the top left, so I guess it evens out once you get to level 7. Maybe they give you, you know, they make it so you don't have to earn much XP for the first level when you upgrade, you know, from level 6 to level 7, just so that you get that excitement of upgrading it nice and quickly. But then they slow it down again, like tease you into wanting to continue using all the weapons and get them leveled up, make you think it's going to be a nice quick process. Hanging a carrot in front of you, as they say. Oh, this is only... This isn't even level 5 yet, though. Yeah, we need to start using this, because this is going to be very difficult to earn any XP with. If we leave it too late. It's going to take so long to transform any of these into sheep, but... Right, level 4, good. Yeah, let's try and get it to level 5, and then everything will be at least level 5 as far as I know. Oh, there's two new guys on the turrets. Where did they come from? Come on. Yeah, see how long it takes for some of these? Once you've got it to level 10 with all the rare retaining upgrades, these guys will be transformed in just like a split second, probably. Oh, come on. Yeah, I'm glad I noticed this was low level now. It would have been a pain to level up later. This will be level 5 now, ready? There we go. Right, Gotenator. We stop using it now until we get it to level 6. So we can afford the upgrade. I'm not sure how much it will be, but... Keep these guys dancing as long as I can. Yeah, I thought I was going to miss that shot. It wasn't locked onto the enemy, but it still hit him for some reason. He shifts down, that'll give us a nice bit of XP. Ah, come on. Right up the top of his head. Okay, no more ammo. Serpent will probably finish him off.
Are those grind boots?
A tripod lock. In order to bypass it, the duo would have to quickly activate all three pressure pads.
It was her kind of hair.
Cool! Grind boots!
Okay.
That's completely
Right, so I'm going to collect these brains for this dude now, whose name always eludes me. Oh man. Not the liveliest of streams, is it? I apologise, guys. There's a game that I need to get done. And so, uploading it to YouTube is kind of an afterthought, but some of you will hopefully find it enjoyable. Oh wow, nice. More inactive zircons can be stored without fire. Okay, increased ammo, cool. This can be useful for our attempts to level this up to max level. I'm gonna take my jump off for a second. Yeah, we can't afford anything else yet, can we? Right, let's go then. Let's get this next part done.
Stylishly leapt onto the rail next to him.
Yes, thank you, Quark. What if I didn't? What if I failed? You'd be a liar.
Detecting Versa mines ahead.
Oh, right. Oh, right. Oh, wasn't looking then.
Oh, wow.
I'm going to finish off this planet, and then I'm going to get some breakfast and be right back once I've done that. Some raritanium down here, I think. Oh, we're gonna check our cards in a second as well. Yeah, let's do that now, because we've probably picked up a few cards that we can trade in the duplicates for.
That's a whole fat. Nice.
A extra bolts. Oh, and another one. Fusion. Hang on. Oh, okay, that's funny. We've already got the Omega Fusion Bomb. So it must have counted, must have known that we'd already completed the set before we actually turned the pack in.
You just completed a set.
And the Gotenator. Oh, and we've got two spare ones. What are we at now? 91%. We're not far off being complete here if we trade this one in. That's 92%. Let's have a look.
Set complete.
And that one, 93. So each card is 1% roughly. So how many have we got left? We've got 1, 2, 3. Hang on, let's do it from the top. 2, 4, 5. I think it's going to be 7, 6, 7. Yeah, okay. 7 cards to go, that's pretty good.
Hey, bear lumber! I'm here.
Oh.
Don't worry, I'm a friend. I know.
Okay, so let's blast through this area and get these first 10 brains that will give us access to the rocket pack.
Nice work.
Did we fill up our ammo? Yeah, I believe we did. Oh, get off me. Got quite a long reach, that guy. Very long reach, longer than his arms. Let's get Zircon out as well. Right, where are these buttons? Okay. Next area. This bomb's pretty cool now, it kind of shoots out shoots out lots of little bombs, like a, I guess a cluster grenade when it goes off. Oh no, don't fall off the edge. got some more fusion bombs here. Let's keep this one going, try and get it out of the way. Come on. Right. What's our lava sighter? Or lava sighter at? Lavasiter. yeah, I'll keep using that a bit as well. Oh, hopefully some food in a quarter of an hour will liven me up a bit. Wake me up.
And with that jetpack, okay. Ratchet became the aerial scourge of a thousand worlds.
Split our ammo. Oh, groover bomb. We're going to be using that anyway, so let's get that upgraded, shall we? Unless there's one that's particularly difficult to... Yeah, that's fine. Groover bomb.
I just might make my quarter this week.
Alternator.
Take your time. No, really.
Actually, let's upgrade that, because once we do buy the next version of it, it does become quite difficult to upgrade fully. It takes a bit of time, especially from level 9 to level 10. So having it at a high level or a high upgrade level with the the Raritanium upgrades, that's the one. what can we use in this game here? Trying to, hey, nice, 7 already. Trying to like no scope his eyes. I'm getting hit a lot. Come on, Tom, sort it out. In fact, this is going to be quite a good area to level up our weapons. Have we got a fill-up station here? Oh, get off me! Come on. Missing his eyes every time that. There he goes, a critical, and another, and another, and another. Got one more hit. There we go.
Gross.
Pick up this health over here.
Getting into my fur.
Right. Here's our upgrade station. Not upgrade, sorry. Our rocket fuel station. Yeah, I might actually do a few more of these brains than I was planning to, just because those telepathicus guys are quite good for leveling up our weapons. Little his son's here now, Zircon's son, Zircon Jr. He's just as funny.
There's a lot of difficult things in my life, but by far the most difficult has been trying to say the word telepathopus 10 times fast. I believe it is impossible. Telepathopus.
Right.
Hey, looks like you found one of my telepathopus. as traps.
Okay, can we get this guy dancing? He's outside. He's always outside the range of it. It's very difficult to get these guys to dance. At least we can slow him down with the plasma striker. Come on. Oh, we've not got any ammo. Oh, here we are. Didn't want to shoot for a second there. Hey, no way. Nice. See, it is a good place to level up, I can say. Except I'm getting hit over and over, and I haven't got any ammo. Yes, I have. It's very strange. This weapon seems to jam or something. Because even when I've got ammo, it doesn't seem to want to let me shoot. Okay, yeah, see, pretty good. Even though we're at level 8, it's given us a decent section just for killing him. Thus, gave us enough to get to level 8 and get that probably a fifth of the way towards level 9. Okay, we need to get to another boost, sort of jetpack refill station. Where is there one? One over there on that platform. Oh no, here's the one I was looking for. Get all these guys dancing, throw out a protoblast. I'm not sure if you only get XP for the Groovatron when the dancing enemies are killed, or whether it gives you XP just for using it. Entirely sure how that works, but we'll try and kill the dancing enemies while they're dancing just to make sure we do get the XP, just in case that is how it functions.
I just realized, if I'm a scientist and I spend all my time studying brains, I should introduce myself at parties as a brain scientist. That sounds much more impressive than a assistant or outpost consultant.
Cards down there, I believe. Yep. Should we see if we can snipe this guy? Oop, wrong one. Snipe him from all the way back here. See if it does any damage. I wonder if we can get his eyes. Not quite. Oh yeah. I don't think he can even see us yet. I'm just trying to work out where the fire's coming from. Oh, we're out of ammo. What can we use? Let's start using our bomb glove. Fusion bomb on some of these big guys, because that will help finish it up. Doesn't do much damage to him. I don't remember hearing that line. That hit him, or is he protected by the shield? Oh yeah, okay, it's took him out.
Sweet, sweet brains. Come to Papa.
tell you what I need to do is just double check that my Twitch stream the name of my stream is correct at the moment, because over the last few days, anyone who's joined the stream on Twitch will know that Twitch has been being a real pain, sort of resetting the game that I'm playing to Fallout, which it has done again. I don't understand it. It doesn't make sense. Twitch is really, for such a popular website, it's really, really extremely shoddy. the actual streaming side of things works okay, but the fact that literally you change the title and you change the game that you're playing, and sometimes it updates, sometimes it doesn't. Sometimes it updates, but then midway through your stream, it will literally reset it, just randomly change it back to the name of the game that you were playing literally weeks ago. I haven't played Fallout 4 on stream for weeks now, and it keeps being reset back to Fallout 4, which makes no sense whatsoever. I mean, I've streamed several other games between having done Fallout and now. Is that gonna reach him? No, it's not. Come on, you've got to be in range of that. And I wonder if we can put a hit blast on top of his head. No, it goes right through. Thought it might do. Oh wow. Zircon's doing pretty well for us. The level 8. Awesome. Is that guy down yet? Can't actually tell. There is a trophy for killing, I think, 40 enemies from midair, like whilst you're flying. Oh, there's like three of them. What? That was buggy, wasn't it? It's like three guys all in one, and they all stuck together behind a bit of, well, behind that jetpack refill. Come on, go down, please. Right, I think they're down, so let's jump on these pads. What can we use? Still, he's not close enough for... Come on, dance. There we go. Finally got him dancing. Here we go for an ice cream and we're done. Oh, good old Zircon. I did actually turn one of these, or actually several of them, into sheep when I was playing before, which was quite funny. It takes a long time, you have to avoid all their fire and just kind of fly around. I suppose if you had the Groovitron active on them, it would be easier.
Disgusting.
Right, we've got seven more to get. Let's try and activate some more of these big dudes that are pretty good for XP. There's one down here, look. Got any sniper ammo left? Nope. Don't let me land. Surely if I landed, I'd be an easier target for you guys. I would have thought you'd want me to land. Oh, there's another turret here. Might shoot some bombs over the top of his head. If I had any left. Oh, okay, big guy. Come over here. See, oh. He's back. Where's our refill station? I think it might be down under the lava. Unless there's one. Nope. Down here. Right, what do we want to do here? Use our big area of effect protoclast. We have got the 20 we need now. I'm wondering if it's worth. You know what I might do? Is just carry on the next planets, because you get more and more XP for each enemy as you progress through the planets. This is a good place for farming weapons, but what we'll do is if we get to the final boss, we've still got weapons that need upgrading, we'll come back here and finish off the rest of the brains, and that'll give us some raritanium as well. Hopefully quite a nice lot of raritanium, because obviously we've already got the box smasher, bolt grabber, combo thing, whatever it's called. So that does carry over from, I think the gadgets that do carry over are the ones that aren't story related. So if there's any gadgets that you picked up that are optional, such as the bolt grabber or the map-o-matic, which you don't need to progress the story, those ones do continue over to your second playthrough. But I think the reason they obviously hold off from carrying over the other gadgets is simply because it would give you access to certain areas before the story meant for you to have access to them, if that makes sense. So, you know, so you'd be able to get to planets too early. You'd be able to get to planets you weren't meant to be at. Right, we'll just get to another station here. Let's do this one last big guy whilst we're here. We're gonna get him dancing straight out of the gate, I think, if he feel less. Cool. Oh, you can shoot these a lot faster than I realised. That's pretty cool. Come on, go down. Right, we've got another fill up station here. Oh, we're not using our Groover Bomb, are we? It will level up pretty easily, to be honest. We might as well. Oh no, we were using it. We were using it on the big guys, but it just wasn't working, was it? Didn't have a wide enough range to pick them up. Just gonna kill a few of these on our way back. He's moving and we're moving at the moment. Want a bit of a conveyor belt thing here. I'm not even worried about these things hitting me. We can start building up our multiplier again on the next planet. They're not gonna kill me, I shouldn't think. Right, let's head on back, shall we? We've got enough jet fuel. Yeah. Going the right way. I think it's over here. Oh yeah, it's where that star is. That's handy. There's not a refill. Oh no, there's a refill over here, yeah. I was gonna say, most of the, well, all of the platforms have got access to a refill station without having to use the jetpack. So if you do run out, you're able to get some more fuel to get you back to, you know, wherever you need to be.
Looks like your combustor could use an upgrade.
Oh, we've only got 138,000. We need to start. Yeah, we need to start getting some multipliers going.
Isn't raritanium awesome?
Also, we're using the weapons that aren't fully upgraded yet, so obviously once you fully upgrade the weapon, you get more bolts from it. I think this one gives you more this one gives you more raritanium. That's what these upgrades are. 100% once you've got them all, I think. Maybe not 8, 16, 24. So what's that, an extra 48% to our raritanium drop rate? That's cool. Anyway, moving on. Rhino can still probably wait. Oh, we've got enough to finish off this one as well. Cool, we're tidying them up nicely. Fusion bomb, we're using that at the moment, aren't we? So let's pop a point into there. Okay, so we've got to start saving, haven't we?
I got all kinds of stuff to make heroes more heroic. Take a look.
What's it going to give us? Raritanium. Looks like quite a lot of it. Maybe 10? 1, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. We get that naturally through gameplay. We will come back here. If we haven't maxed our weapons by the time we get to the final boss, we'll probably come back and do a bit more farming for those brains, get the raritanium, and also get a nice lot of XP for those big guys.
I know there's more stuff out there in Gaspar.
Okay, I think we're going to get to Batalia, and then I'm going to go and get my food. This time I ate. I've waited an hour. So just hop out the ship, Ratchet. Come on. There we go. So if we pause it here, I'm going to stop the stream there, guys. I'm going to quit the game as well, so that when we come back in, you guys will see which planet we're on, because we'll kind of fly back in. But thanks for watching, anybody who's checking this out on YouTube. And I will catch you all in a bit.